Monday, November 7, 2016, 7:36 a.m. Look at it. I'm in my bedroom, no TV, nothing's on. Only some light coming in from the windows. Like I do every day, I walk into this mother room, and you know the bitches already had turned up to a 7.0 in here. Now I just turned the light on. TV is off. See that red light? TV is off. Computer is off. All I did was turn the light on and watch this. Now the bitches got it turned down to below a 5.0, right? Watch how quick the bitch turned it up. I ain't even finished talking, the bitch already turned it up.
About this, and they're also so well informed. It's incredible. I mean, you've all been around, you've talked to voters over the years, and sometimes you hit a voter and say, you know, who's running again? Everybody knows who's running. Everybody knows what's at stake. Everybody knows what the issues are. Mm-hmm. And everybody agrees on one thing. They cannot wait till tomorrow is up.
We hear that over and over again. No accident that all the campaigns are converging in Philadelphia tonight. We have the president there, the first lady, along with the Clintons. Donald Trump will be there. As well, and you spend a lot of time both in that city and the surrounding suburbs, which is really a bellwether for the whole country.
It really is a bellwether for the whole country, what happens in those so-called collar areas right around Philadelphia. But I also look out in western Pennsylvania, and I think more than anything, that state shows.
We find out that you know anything about Matt Turnbull, who is the most of this monster riding on
Star witness David Wildstein said,
"Can't be charged more than men for health insurance, okay? And number four,
you don't really want to watch, but hey, you've come this far.
I'm bringing in Tom Hanks to question Trump over his assertion that the media is out to get him.
And all of the newscasters are making me look so bad.
And how are we doing that?
by taking all of the things I say and all of the things I do and putting them on TV.
But the real Trump is unimpressed, tweeting that Baldwin's impression stinks. But Clinton didn't come out unscathed, McKinnon repeatedly ducking questions about the email controversy.
Let's get to what's obviously the big story of the week.
Please be his taxes, please be his taxes, please be his taxes.
Secretary Clinton's emails.
Week after week.
So you're just never going to answer a question about your email?
No, but it was very cute to watch you try.
Now, with one of the most heated campaigns ever wrapping up, the comedians are getting serious.
None of this will have mattered if you don't vote.
And we can't tell you who to vote for, but on Tuesday, we all get a chance to choose what kind of country we want to live in.
And live from New York, it's 7
And this election season has been very good to SNL, seen its best ratings in nearly 8 years, and the audience for its premiere alone was 29% higher than last year. But there was something about seeing them, Kate McKinnon and Alec Baldwin, out on the streets of New York that was actually very moving. I thought when I watched it,
it taps into something real. Like, you wish that everyone could just cut it out after this.
Yeah.
And I wish you could get from
30
Rock to Times Square back on a normal day. All right, Hoda, thank you very much.
Cameras over in the Orange and Carson's on voice duty this week. What you got?
Oh, so much, guys. Good morning. Seeing Alec Baldwin and Kate McKinnon break down party barriers and then break out of character, as Hoda mentioned on the show, had so many people reacting online. Check out this one from actor Josh Gad. He tweeted, "The end of tonight's SNL cold open was profound, unexpected, and one of the most essential moments I've ever seen on the show. Bravo.
If they had. So you're saying you have no recollection? Not saying I can swear to you that they never said anything like that. You're saying I don't remember.
I don't remember any of it. But what I will tell you is this, Charles. If they would have told me that, hey, we're creating traffic at the George Washington Bridge in order to punish the mayor for not endorsing you, I would have remembered that. And they never said that. In fact, in the whole trial, by the way, Charlie, I think this is a really important point. In the whole trial, no one, not even Bridget Kelly, Bill Baroni, or David Wildstein, ever testified that anyone ever said to me that this was an act of political retribution.
This is the Washington Post. Governor Chris Christie's political career suffered a serious blow. It taints his legacy. His job approval is at 21%. 52% of the people said,
make a difference. Like how every vitamin and flu shot you get at Walgreens helps give life-changing vitamins and vaccines to children in need. So really,
happy things for giving.
Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
My precious little oranges, destined for greatness, to create the most perfectly delicious orange juice in the world. Simply orange. Apparently, the juice doesn't fall far from the tree.
People spend less time lying awake with aches and pains with Advil PM than with Tylenol PM. Advil PM combines the number one pain reliever with the number one sleep aid. Gentle, non-habit forming Advil PM for a healing night's sleep.
You said you wanted to feel better about your cereal. General Mills Big G cereals hear you. That's why we say yes to whole grain as our first ingredient. No way to high fructose corn syrup. So no matter what your favorite is, you can feel good about General Mills Big G cereals.
What a lovely home you have.
Is this your family?
Yeah, that's my daughter, my son, and that's...
Hey, great man!
Let's go.
Hey, at least you got your homeowner's insurance through Progressive. By bundling it with your car insurance, you saved a ton.
Yeah. Do you want to see the rest of the house?
I can actually see a lot of it.
Generally speaking, I know you're looking at the steam there. Looks like a lot of wind, but it's not. We have a gentle breeze facing out of the north and just slowly moving that out of the picture. 41 degrees right now until 9 o'clock, just for that those areas shaded on radar. We have a frost about
Don't tough it out. Knock it out fast.
Abreva.
Used to prevent shingles in adults 50 years of age and older. Zostavax does not protect everyone and cannot be used to treat shingles or the nerve pain that may follow it. You should not get Zostavax if you are allergic to gelatin or neomycin, have a weakened immune system, or take high doses of steroids, are pregnant, or plan to become pregnant. The most common side effects include redness, pain, itching, swelling, hard lump, warmth, or bruising at the injection site, and headache. It's important to talk to your doctor about what situations you may need to avoid, since Zostavax contains a weakened chickenpox virus. Remember, one in three people get shingles in their lifetime. Will it be you? Talk to your doctor. Side effects include redness, pain, itching, swelling, hard lump, warmth, or bruising at the injection site, and headache. It's important to talk to your doctor about what situations you may need to avoid, since Zostavax contains a weakened chickenpox virus. Remember, one in three people get shingles in their lifetime. Will it be you? Talk to your doctor or pharmacist about me. Single shot Zostavax. You've got a...
Just as a massive show support for Michael Bublé's family as he announces his three-year-old son's cancer diagnosis.
And then Carpe Diem, Jason Sudeikis stops by to talk about bringing a classic film to Broadway.
And what everyone is freezing for the internet's hottest new challenge after local news.
Always the kind of challenge that won't be lost.
My favorite part is to be able to lift your legs up a little bit, lift the head up a little bit, and it feels like I'm just cradled.
Sleep happy at Mattress Firm when you save up to $600 on select Tempur-Pedic mattress sets and get 0% APR for 5 years.
And there you have it.
Visit Mattress Firm, America's number one Tempur-Pedic retailer today, and sleep happy tonight.
Is the youngest men's winner in the history of the New York Marathon. He finished in just under 2 hours and 8 minutes. Mary Kitani of Kenya won the women's race, becoming the first woman to win three in a row in 30 years. Her closest competitor was more than 3 minutes behind.
She was 2 hours and 24 minutes.
Molly Huddle of USA came in third place.
Well, she 28 minutes. That's nice. Yep. Donald Trump's campaign manager will join us coming up.
Eat them matters.
So you're saying we need to talk to somebody who actually knows something about dog food?
Yep.
At Petco, nutrition is our priority. That's why we carry Natural Balance, like sweet potato and fish formula, a simple, grain-free recipe with limited ingredients. Now $5 off. Or save up to 20% and get free shipping when you sign up for repeat delivery at Petco.com. Petco.
Serve a turkey. Don't serve a turkey. Bring classic flaky crescent rolls or not-so-classic chicken sticks. Don't forget something sweet and golden brown fresh from the oven.
It's holiday time, and no boot is as versatile as our ocean spray cranberry, which is why we're declaring it the unofficial official fruit of the holidays.
Steak's gonna be so bummed.
For holiday tips and recipes, go to oceanspray.com.
Before Danny got what he was dreaming about for the holidays, before his mom earned 1% cash back everywhere, every time, and his dad earned 2% back at grocery stores and wholesale clubs, even before they earned 3% back on gas, Danny's parents used their Bank America Cash Rewards credit card to give him the best day ever. That's the joy of rewarding connections. Learn more at bankofamerica.com/getcashback.
Listerine kills 99% of bad breath germs for 100% fresh mouth. Feeling 100% means you feel bold enough to assist a magician or dance. Listerine, bring out the bold.
Does your child need help with digestive balance? Try Align Junior Probiotic so she can have a fraction dominating, status updating, hello yellow belt kind of day. Get 24/7 digestive support with Align Junior, the number one doctor recommended probiotic brand. Now for kids.
When L'Oreal asked me what I wanted my skin to be, I said bright, smooth, you know, with a little glow.
New Bright Reveal from L'Oreal with glycolic acid reveals brighter skin and visibly reduces wrinkles in just 1 week. New Bright Reveal from L'Oreal Paris.
We gotta go through a whole ocean of bad.
From creators of Frozen and Zootopia, this Thanksgiving.
I thought you were a monster.
Disney Moana, November 23rd in 3D rated PG.
Can't see it, can't taste it, but there's so much more to it. Here's how Venom Fiber works. Inside us are trillions of good microflora that support digestive health. The prebiotic fiber and beta fiber nourishes them.
And what helps them helps you.
Clear, taste-free Venom Fiber.
At Progresso, we are now using 100% antibiotic and hormone-free white breast meat chicken in all our chicken soups. Behold our greatest opus.
Tonight, Found welcomes the World Series champion Chicago Cubs, Anthony Rizzo, Dexter Fowler, and Ben Zobrist. Plus a staring contest with Alicia Keys and Bill Maher. Then Seth has John Goodman, New Found, New Late Night, NBC Tonight.
They look good, huh?
Yeah, it's a lot.
Andre Hepkins joins WBAL TV 11 News.
Good evening, we start with some breaking news.
Weeknights at 5 on WBAL and at 10 on MeTV Baltimore.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Jason Newton, 756 right now. Ava and Sarah join us. Let's start with traffic. How's it look?
We have 795 problems, actually. We have an accident coming in on the southbound side of 795 right near McDonough Road, and that's why we're seeing those delays down toward the Beltway. And this is what it looks like leading up to it, obviously, delayed in the southbound direction. Southbound 95, pretty heavy. Those delays go all the way back toward Mountain Road. You're at 23 miles per hour, all due to an earlier crash, but obviously volume is playing a role as well. Liberty Road at 32, we have an accident coming in Eldersburg, so use caution there. Looks like our biggest delay is on the west side. Of course, it's right at 38 minutes through that stretch. Patuxent Range at Washington Boulevard tracking a crash. We also have one coming in at Bel Air Road and Honeygo Boulevard if you're heading out the door there. So a lot going on at the moment.
And there's a chill in the
air. Yeah, it's still chilly. Yeah. Trying to climb out of the 30s right now in the suburbs. The sun is shining. Eventually, it will hit the 40s. We're there already at BWI, downtown Baltimore at 45, but Jarrettsville, we're still at 35 degrees. 40s by 9 a.m., 53 by noon, and upper 50s this afternoon. Sun sets earlier than we expect because of the time change. Should be getting dark after 5 p.m. But before that, we hit 60 in Hagerstown and 60 in Oakland. Storm system well off to our west, so we're dry for a couple of days. That should be arriving on Wednesday with more clouds, maybe a few showers. Doesn't look like a washout, but behind that, a drop in temperatures. Especially if we go into Saturday, another stronger system arrives, and that could keep us in the 40s to kick off the weekend.
Dark by 5 p.m., we're getting used to that.
I know. That's a hard.
That is tough.
Back line at 5.
Back line at 8:26. We'll see you there.
Tonight at 7:30 on 11 News.
Hi,
this message. What's your definition of insanity? Mine is voting the same way over and over and expecting a different result. Like sending Chris Van Hollen to Washington. Higher taxes, huge deficits, a VA that doesn't work. As a career politician, Van Hollen's fixed none of it. Working with Governor Hogan, we're changing Maryland. Next stop, Washington, D.C. Join me.
I'm Mike from Glen Burnie. When I'm not running my business, I'm busy coaching my son's Little League teams. I'm always on the go. So when I went to buy my new vehicle, there's only one place. Browns. Quick, easy, and affordable.
Visit BrownsCar.com today.
5,000 years of Chinese music and dance in one night. Incredible. Groundbreaking. Cultural phenomenon.
Larry, listen up. Shingles, we've been protecting this roof for years. And it's time to go.
Tell me about it. I can't hold my water anymore.
Uh-oh, I'm gonna leak in their bedroom.
These blotches and stains are showing my age. The homeowner needs to show us some love.
Maybe your roof is telling you it's time to call Long Roofing before it's too late.
And pick four midday drawings are on TV 11.
Which is a great project. Now you can see our stubble growing. In our survey, 92% of guys told us mental health issues are going underreported. So we're going to try to do our part as we raise awareness for men's health month.
like to remind people why you guys are supposed to get blamed for a good cause. Now let's get a check on today's headlines. Here's the news at 8. We begin with the race for the contest in Welford in Manchester, New Hampshire. After 24 hours of this race, Hillary Clinton getting some welcome news. The FBI saying there's nothing there in its review of thousands of newly discovered emails. Its review now concluded, but Donald Trump is gaining ground and isn't letting up.
I'm downstairs cooking, but I'm letting this record.
This morning, Hillary Clinton vindicated over her latest email controversy. But staying on message, delivering her closing argument in New Hampshire Sunday.
This election is a moment of reckoning. It is a choice between division or unity.
This after a November surprise. Sunday, FBI Director James Comey announcing the new probe into Clinton's emails is over, writing in a letter to Congress, based on our review, we have not changed our conclusions that we expressed in July with respect to Secretary Clinton. NBC News has learned the review of thousands of emails found on Anthony Weiner's laptop established nearly all of those to and from Clinton while she was Secretary of State were duplicates, or they weren't related to government business at all.
He just reiterated.
Weiner is the estranged husband of Clinton's top aide, Huma Abedin. Clinton not mentioning the FBI decision all day, instead leaving that to her team.
I'm not surprised. I mean, I really felt like the original conclusion was so unequivocal.
Donald Trump, who crisscrossed five states Sunday trying to shore up a narrow path to 270, not letting up.
Right now, she is being protected by a rigged system.
After praising Director Comey nearly 2 weeks ago for looking into the newly discovered emails.
I respect that very much.
At Sunday in Michigan, Trump reversed course.
You can't review 650,000 new emails in 8 days.
Campaign manager Kellyanne Conway piling on.
Do you think that they went through hundreds of thousands of emails in a week? Because that may strike a lot of Americans as unusual.
Now the focus for both candidates, getting out the vote.
Vote for yourselves, vote for your children, vote for your grandchildren.
In her final push today, Clinton will barnstorm Pennsylvania, Michigan, and North Carolina. Trump, who has been catching up in recent polls, hitting five states, Florida, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, New Hampshire, and Michigan, a blue state he's fighting to turn red.
Hillary Clinton is guilty. She knows it. The FBI knows it.
And we are getting our final snapshot of this race. Our NBC News SurveyMonkey online poll out today shows Secretary Clinton with a 6-point lead nationally in a 4-way matchup. According to one of Secretary Clinton's top campaign officials, she will be releasing her latest ad tonight, 2 minutes of Clinton talking straight to camera, her final argument before all voters have their say. Matt, Savannah.
All right, Kristen Walker, thank you. And of course, NBC News has you covered on Election Day. We'll get things started right here on today. And then our special primetime coverage beginning at 7 p.m. Eastern. And we will, of course, have all of the results on today, Wednesday morning.
We hope we'll have all the results on Wednesday morning. You never know. Other news now. People in Oklahoma are assessing the damage this morning caused by a strong earthquake that rumbled through that state on Sunday night. The 5.0 magnitude quake struck near the city of Cushing. That's a major oil hub about 50 miles to the southwest of Tulsa. No major injuries are reported, but the shaking did damage some buildings. Schools are closed today so officials can make sure they're safe. The quake was felt as far away as Iowa, Illinois, and Texas.
A popular fall tradition in Delaware has been marred by a serious accident. This happened Sunday. The video captures the incident. Parts of an air cannon that fires pumpkins through the air exploded when it was fired. The parts, including a metal door, struck a 39-year-old woman in the head and the face. This morning, she's reported in critical condition at a local hospital. A 56-year-old man also was hurt, but his injuries were not life-threatening.
Just ahead, a difficult battle ahead for Michael Bublé and his family as his son is diagnosed with cancer.
And then the one thing all voters seem to agree on, why this campaign has our stress and anxiety levels at an all-time high.
And on trending, the internet's newest obsession, get ready for the mannequin challenge that even stars are freezing for. But first, these messages.
It's dry.
your scalp might get strained in winter too. Try Head & Shoulders Dry Scalp Care. It nourishes the scalp three surface layers deep to help prevent dryness. It keeps you up to 100% flake free. Now we can cuddle the whole winter. Head & Shoulders Dry Scalp Care.
Can you feel something without touching it? See something with your eyes closed. When everything is designed around you, the driver, you can. The new Mazda 3.
My trainer didn't believe me that Chop 50 could taste so good and still have 50% fewer calories.
Can I stop, Jane?
No. Chop 50 tastes so good you won't believe it has 50% fewer calories.
Pro golfer. My psoriatic arthritis caused joint pain.
Just like my moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis.
And I was worried about joint damage.
My doctor said joint pain from RA can be a sign of existing joint damage that could only get worse. He prescribed Enbrel to help relieve pain and help stop further damage.
Enbrel may lower your ability to fight infections. Serious, sometimes fatal events, including infections, tuberculosis, lymphoma, other cancers, nervous system and blood disorders, and allergic reactions have occurred. Tell your doctor if you've been someplace where fungal infections are common, or if you're prone to infections, have cuts or sores, have had hepatitis B, have been treated for heart failure, or if you have persistent fever, bruising, bleeding, or paleness. Don't start Enbrel if you have an infection like the flu.
Joint pain and damage
can go side by side. Ask how Enbrel can help relieve joint pain and help stop joint damage.
Enbrel, the number one rheumatologist prescribed biologic.
News from singer Michael Bublé.
He and his wife have announced that their three-year-old son Noah has cancer. They are putting their careers on hold to help him get well. Natalie is in Los Angeles with more on this. Natalie, good morning.
Good morning to you guys. Yeah, such sad news. The couple's devotion to their two children is evident in all that they do. The family goes on tour together, and their home life is frequently the highlight of their social media accounts. This diagnosis, family members say, has broken them in half.
The stunning announcement from the couple posted Friday on Facebook. We are devastated about the recent cancer diagnosis of our oldest son, Noah, who is currently undergoing treatment in the U.S. Someday I know it'll all turn out. The Canadian singer writing, "We have always been very vocal about the importance of family and the love we have for our children. Luisana and I have put our careers on hold in order to devote all our time and attention to helping Noah get well." Bublé and his wife, model Luisana Lopilato, did not confirm the type of cancer Noah has, but Bublé's sister-in-law told an Argentinian TV station that it is not leukemia. It's cancer, but it's not leukemia, nor is it in his central nervous system, as they've been saying. On social media, an outpouring of sympathy from fans and friends. Singer Rod Stewart tweeting, "All our love to Noah." Harry Connick Jr. writing, "Let's all pray for Noah so he can win this fight." And Shannon Doherty, who is battling breast cancer, had this to say at an American Cancer Society function this Saturday. "I can't even begin to touch that one, to be honest, because it's a three-year-old. I would imagine your child having cancer is devastating as a parent." Childhood cancers are extremely rare and make up less than 1% of all cancers diagnosed in the U.S., but cancer is still the leading cause of death from disease in children.
childhood cancer has a much higher cure rate than adults. We cure nearly 80% overall as a group of our kids diagnosed with cancer, which is much higher than an adult with cancer.
In addition to their son Noah, Michael Bublé and his wife also have a 9-month-old son, Eli. Bublé often brings his family on tour with him and regularly includes them in his pre-concert rituals. Bublé writing, "At this difficult time, we ask only for your prayers and respect for our privacy. We have a long journey in front of us and hope that with the support of family, friends, and fans around the world, we will win this battle, God willing."
And Michael and Lisanna have been married since 2011. As we mentioned, they're also parents to 9-month-old Elias. We wish them all, and of course, Noah, excuse me, the very best. Guys, back to you.
Certainly do, Natalie. Thank you very much for that.
All right, we'll turn to Al.
All right, let's look and give you an idea of what's going on across the country today. We're looking at some wet weather moving into the Pacific Northwest. We've got frontal system that's going to be bringing rain from Minneapolis all the way down, heavier rain and showers and thunderstorms down through the lower Gulf Coast. Here's that front pushing through on Election Day. Really, the only big problem is going to be Ohio. We're looking at showers there in the battleground states. Wet weather down through the Gulf, on into Texas. Record highs in the Pacific Northwest. Plenty of sunshine, Utah, and on into Arizona. Along the eastern seaboard tomorrow, we've got great weather to talk about as well. That's what's going on around the country. Here's what's happening in your neck of the woods.
It's a chilly morning, but with sunshine, we'll warm up through the 40s and 50s this morning and eventually hit the upper 50s through the afternoon, back down to 47 at 7 p.m. and 41 at 10 p.m. 30s again tonight, 60s tomorrow, then rain showers possible Wednesday.
Join Radcliffe Jewelers for our biggest event of the year. Our annual holiday show is a unique opportunity to view the world of fine jewelry and watches. This Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at Radcliffe Jewelers, downtown center, Knoxville.
That's your latest weather, and before we get to trending, we want to issue congratulations to Craig Melvin and his wife, Lindsay, welcoming a baby girl on Saturday, Sybil Sidney Ann. That's just so fantastic, and she joins her big brother, Dell, and we are so happy for that. Oh, look at that. Look at that. They come in so small. Congratulations to everybody.
That used to be the way.
Adorable family, our best to them. Okay, let's go to trending.
There are the two words that strike fear in the heart of every wedding guest: drunk uncle. No, actually the opposite: dry wedding. Meaning no alcohol will be served this morning. It's sparking a debate on the internet as a growing number of couples opt for dry weddings. A lot of people say banning alcohol prevents people from doing dumb things at a wedding and ruining the day. Also, it is a lot cheaper. But others say alcohol helps people loosen up and have more fun. What a shock that comes from you. On Twitter, we asked you, are alcohol-free weddings sensible or are they stingy? What do you think the results would be?
I think stingy.
62% say stingy. 38% call them sensible.
Well, I mean, the booze is like the most expensive part of the wedding. Besides, especially with the friends we all have.
Have you ever been to a wedding where someone had over?
It's not. Having a good time's a good time.
That's true. Well, food waste. Me too. There's a new app that's trying to be part of the solution when it comes to food waste and leftover. It's called Food for All. Here's what it does. It lets you buy the food that restaurants have left over before they close for the night. So you buy the food that didn't sell that day. You'll get it for 50 to 80% less. It's an app that's in development right now. I think an MBA student came up with it, which is really cool. The creator's raising money on Kickstarter, hopes to launch the app next summer. Do we like this idea?
Yes.
I like it if it doesn't take away from another great idea, which is a lot of restaurants in cities like New York donate what they have left over to shelters and people who don't get a good meal otherwise.
Yeah, I like that. But I also like the idea that restaurants, the hard business. Yeah. You can take that food that would have been wasted and make money on it.
Yeah, make sure that there's a specialty dish and they have something left over, ingredients, go pick it up.
Sure.
So I like it.
I'm going to mention a couple of things. Just tell me
me if you're with me and you remember this.
Okay.
Ice bucket challenge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The water bottle challenge.
Yeah.
Now the latest internet craze is called the mannequin challenge.
Oh.
It involves people making a dramatic pose and then freezing in place to look like mannequins.
Uh-huh.
This challenge started with high school students, but now it's spread to celebrities like Kevin Hart and athletes like members of the New York Giants and the Pittsburgh Steelers. We've had enough of this. Declan.
We didn't even plan this.
Do pop start.
Celebrities turned out on Sunday for the annual New York City Marathon. Olivia Wilde shared this video from the sidelines as she and other spectators cheered on the runners. Drew Barrymore also in the house. She and her husband, Will Koppelman, finalized this divorce back in August, but Drew showed up to support her ex and shared this photo of the couple dying, giving them a hug after the race.
And look at how the bitch starting to turn it up. Almost 43 minutes in.
This race has been stressful on both.
Well, you see what it's done to
Alex. Holly Jackson's here with that part of the story. Holly, so many people are saying it. They just feel sick to the stomach.
And it's not just that I'm not saying it.
Yeah, everybody is stressed out about this. Not to totally bring down the mood, but there are more than 60% of voters now in our new poll who say they're actually less proud of America right now because of this election. That is more than 5 times the number that we saw back in 2008. Regardless of the surprises and what you think it should be, there's one thing that we know for sure. The mood of this nation is stressed out.
After nearly 600 days of a grueling, grinding campaign, tomorrow cannot come soon enough for most of us.
I'm stressed because I just think the candidates have such different views that there's going to be a lot of people that are angry either way.
The United States just seems like there's so much animosity right now. No one wants to just, I don't know, as corny as it sounds, just get along.
Is election stress like the one thing right now that's actually bringing everybody together?
No, that's a great question. I think in a lot of ways it is, yeah.
Regardless of whether they lean red or blue, recent surveys show more than half of Americans are disgusted with this campaign and call the election a significant source of stress in their lives. It's not just the frayed nerves, but the fatigue. We really are losing sleep, getting less of it after big moments like debates, where the rhetoric's ratcheted up more than ever, it seems.
It's to replenish the
such a nasty
trust. I am sick and tired of the negative, dark, divisive, dangerous vision and behavior.
These have been very antagonistic campaigns, filled with a lot of angry, negative rhetoric. We also think that social media is playing a role in people's amount of election-related stress.
I think especially I'm seeing it on Facebook with the insane statuses, all the Instagrams, everyone's pretty sick of it.
I have blocked a lot of people that I thought were friends, and I just had to hide them on Facebook.
Facebook says they've had 5.3 billion likes, posts, comments, and shares related to 2016 in the first 9 months of this year alone. Not easy to escape an election that's everywhere.
I actually stopped watching most of the news about it months ago.
Because you were getting too stressed?
Yeah, it was too bothersome, all the sound bites and the quotes, and I had basically made up my mind.
The good news? This 2016 slog, soon to be history.
Hopefully it's a reaction of relief, I'm hoping, but I guess it's really going to depend on who gets it.
Still, a word of warning.
I don't expect everyone to feel 100% better come Wednesday morning. If the candidate that you supported didn't win, you're likely to be disappointed, and there's going to be a period of time where you will likely feel angry and sadness.
After 594 days, a few more in store as the election hangover hangs around.
And while we may talk about a gender gap in this campaign, there is not one when it comes to all this. The American Psychological Association says men and women are equally likely to say 2016 is stressing them out. I know it's a bummer, but at least we
Yeah, but you're right. It's not like after the election they're all good. It doesn't mean anything.
You're a right friend, all the people you unfriend them, you know.
Callie, thank you very much. Coming up, Jason Sudeikis is here. He's going to talk about family fun and tackling an iconic role.
And we've got a special preview of the Radio City Christmas Spectacular.
Forecast for the day, mid-40s now, 60 is a high later on. Problem on the JFX. Sharon, take it away, the last report.
Yeah, not in a great area. 83 southbound at Ruxton Road. We have a crash there, and you can see a big jam right before it and continuing on after it. So watch for that in the southbound direction. Also still following on a few other roads, including one of them on Liberty Heights. That's going to be at Howard Park Road, also East Cold Spring at Lock Raven, South Marlin at Sandalwood, and Liberty at Green. If you're headed out on the Beltway, speed's extremely slow still. That's a lie. Look at that west side delay at I-70. This traffic report is brought to you by Horizon Services for all your plumbing, heating, and cooling needs. Visit horizonservices.com. Back over to you, Lynn.
Thanks, Sharon. A Maryland law student is beaten to death outside a club in Toronto. Now police are looking for suspects. Mike Shue reports on the bachelor party turned crime scene.
Good morning, Lynn. Good morning, everyone. Julian Jones is from Glen Burnie. Went to school here at UB Law and was in Toronto for a bachelor party. Police say as the bars let out early Saturday, Jones was separated from his group, was surrounded by 7 to 9 men who egged him on to fight. He refused and was beaten and died there on the sidewalk. Police say that they're going to release the many surveillance video they have of the suspects and tell them to turn themselves in. His dad tells the Toronto Sun that his son was a loving and caring man. I'm Aisha WJZ Eyewitness News. Lynn, back to you.
Police at the University of Maryland College Park investigate after two people were shot with a BB gun. It happened last night on Stadium Drive. Police say they received reports of a person in a dark-colored car driving around firing a BB gun at students. Two students were struck, but neither was injured. Anyone with information should call police. A Baltimore County fire truck collided with a passenger vehicle yesterday on West Seminary Avenue while on its way to a call. No one was seriously injured. The road was shut down, though, for a short time while the scene was cleaned up. The accident is now under investigation. The neonatal intensive care unit at the Prince George's Hospital Center has shut down for the second time in nearly 3 months. This after a potentially deadly bacteria was detected in two infants. Officials say one of the children is being treated. The other shows no signs of ill effect. On Friday, the hospital center announced it has called in federal experts to help fix the problem. Today is your last chance to see the Brazilian naval ship, the M.E. Brazil, while docked at the Inner Harbor. The boat docked there Thursday and has offered free tours for those wanting to get up close and personal with the ship and the crew. It will depart today at 2 p.m. And stay with WJZ 13, Maryland's news station. Up next, a political roundtable with some political experts, Peggy Noonan, Dan Sr., and Alex Wagner. Plus, a group of seventh graders explain how they would handle the election when they're old enough to vote.
What do car dealers and Jiffy Lube have in common? They both use the same manufacturer's recommendations when servicing your vehicle. Stop into Jiffy Lube today.
Let Colby Electric repair or replace your ceiling fans, outlet switches, light fixtures, or circuit breakers. Call Colby Electric today for all your electrical needs. Now through Wednesday, get $50 off your first service call.
Keeping our lights bright, Colby Electric.
Which service makes your home the best home for the holidays?
With Xfinity X1, you can search for all of your favorites. Just talk right into your remote.
Show me holiday news. That is super easy.
During the holidays, more people come over. Let's bring out your extended family. 7 devices using the same network.
No buffering, no slowing down.
How does this compare to your service at home?
Much better.
Get ready for the holidays with this great limited time offer. Plus, we've recently increased our speeds. Ask how you get a free speed upgrade for a year. Click, call, or visit an Xfinity store today.
Call the family of Michael and Son for all your heating needs. And turn to the experts at Carrier for a limited time. Get an $89 precision furnace tune-up by calling 800-948-MIKE or visit MichaelandSon.com.
I'm Kathy Shalaya, and I approve this message. What's your definition of insanity? Mine is voting the same way over and over and expecting a different result. Like sending Chrissy and Holland to Washington. Higher taxes, huge deficits, a VA that doesn't work. As a career politician, Van Hollen's fixed none of it. Working with Governor Hogan, we are changing Maryland. Next stop, Washington.
Who will lead our country? Who will represent us in the U.S. Senate? WJZ's Vic Carter reports from the White House. Campaign coverage, direct from Washington, D.C. Tonight, it's on WJZ.
Charlie, would you have guessed that Gail and I have been singing this all morning? I appreciate this clip.
Exactly.
Going to stay with you all day long. Welcome back. Congratulations again to Chicago. It's a great story there. Welcome back to CBS This Morning. Coming up in this half hour on this last day of presidential campaign. Can you believe it? We are here. We have an all-star political panel. There's Peggy Noonan. There she is. Peggy Noonan, Dan Senor, and Alex Wagner are over at our election night decision desk. They'll give their takes on the candidates' last-minute ground games and what it will take to go, Alex. Strike a pose, Mrs. Cass. It'll take to reach 270 electoral votes.
Seventh graders cannot vote for president until 2024, but this election has helped them prepare ahead. The advice they wrote for themselves in a special edition of our series, Note to Self.
Time to show you some of this morning's headlines. The Wall Street Journal reports on new discovery that could widen the Volkswagen emission scandal. California regulators say some Audis are rigged to evade carbon dioxide rules. The software was found in gas and diesel-powered models. Mm-hmm. Volkswagen already faces billions in cost for rigging diesels to cheat on anti-smog test. VW and federal regulators have not publicly disclosed this latest discovery.
The New York Times warns about hundreds of fake retail apps popping up before the holidays. They were in the Apple's App Store in recent weeks. Now, some of these fake apps contain malware that can steal your personal information or lock up a phone for ransom. Yikes. Apple says it has removed suspicious apps and remains vigilant.
The Washington Post states the case against moving our clocks back the fall. In the fall, switching out of daylight savings is linked to a rise in crime. Statistics also show an increase in deadly car crashes. And a new study says diagnoses of depression jump more than 10%. Experts say long days and ample sunshine can protect against depressive symptoms.
I thought that extra hour sleep was a good thing.
I feel happy.
I do too. The Daily Cameron Boulder says a pregnant woman, this is a great story, a pregnant woman in labor did something very important before giving birth. She voted. She and her husband stopped by the clerk's office to cast her ballots Friday before going to the hospital. The woman unexpectedly went into labor a few days early. The husband says it's really important for us to bring our little girl into a world where we are proud of. That's commitment.
Did she say who she voted for?
She did not say. She did not say.
This is the final day of the 2016 presidential campaign. Most voters in a new CBS News poll say they expect Hillary Clinton to win. She leads Donald Trump by 24 points on that question. The poll was taken before FBI Director James Comey cleared Clinton again in the email investigation. With us now are Wall Street Journal columnist and CBS News contributor Peggy Noonan. Dan
Easy decision with the elements in the story. Easy in the sense that it's an amazing character. I think it's a tremendous story. Still relevant.
Have you seen Harry?
Shining as Harry, your childhood crush. So,
wow.
Dreams do come true.
Okay. Wait, what was that?
You're picking on me shamelessly.
Cutest human being I've ever seen in my life. This is y'all's party. Harry.
Weekdays at 4 on ABC 2.
Right this minute. All the craziest. No way. Can you believe they just did that video? All rolled up into one show. Seriously. Do yourself a favor. Watch.
Weekdays at noon on ABC 2.
Hey, baby.
Terry McMillan, you still reading, waiting to catch hell?
Good that when we hold hands, it's like less likely that we're going to wipe out of So we hold hands, we walk really slow. But this time we were in gowns, so we had to walk extra slow because it's so nerve-wracking when the camera's on you and you're walking. So even walking out there, even walking out there, I'm like, don't fall. The floor's a little slippery.
You're a gymnast. What do you mean, don't fall?
But
talk about nerve-wracking. How nerve-wracking to teach the president how to do splits?
Well, he wasn't very good at it. It wasn't that nerve-wracking because he couldn't really do it. But it's okay. He gets an A for effort.
How do you teach someone that can't do it? Like, what do you...
We just told him good job. Yeah, exactly. He wasn't very good at it. That's why he didn't really try it.
That's a tough thing. Of all the things you could have taught him, a split is sort of...
It's his idea, though, so I don't know. He just say yes, good job, smile.
Do a cartwheel, maybe.
Yeah, we should have asked him to do a cartwheel.
A horse would have been a good call.
Yeah. It would have been hard in a suit, though, you know?
Yeah, sure. Those Armani threads.
Yeah.
How's the tour going?
It's great. We actually just had 4 shows in a row, and we only have 1 week left.
Oh. You've explained to everybody how it works. Tell us about it.
We've been pretty much gone since September 5th. The first show was September 14th. The last show is actually in Boston, where I live. It's November 13th, so I'm very excited. Mm-hmm. And it's 36 cities, 38 shows. So we've been sleeping on tour buses. It's been so much fun. It's definitely a totally different experience. It's kind of a way for people to see our personality. We do gymnastics, but we're also having fun. The last number is like all these mixes of 80s songs. So we're all in like these bright colors and stuff. It's really awesome. We have a really good time. And
were you guys born then?
No, I was born in 94. But I know all the songs. I do know the songs.
She's the senior.
I'm sure
the 80s are back. And you know who was also back on Dancing with the Stars? Yes. She's doing so well.
I went to watch her the second week, and I hope I can go watch her again. But she's so good.
Did you give her some advice because she'd done it before?
No, she really needs to give me some advice. She's so good.
Disney
Channel. She's just like, she's like a star. She's so good at everything. It's a great idea. They probably just picked up. Hey, she's so
bubbly. Yeah, Disney Channel should hire her.
Yeah, I'm really digging. 10%.
Okay.
And we've got a big dog adoption update coming up as well. The whole thing.
Then let's see. Lead political reporter Kate Amar.
We're hoping that happens, but it is true.
16 political coverage on air, online, and on our mobile app on WBAL TV 11 News. Your family's comfort is our priority at Arundel Cooling, Heating, and Electrical. Serving the metro area, Arundel is Carrier's premier factory-authorized dealer. Turn to the experts. Call Arundel Cooling today or visit us at arundelcooling.com.
I believe America is already great. Yes, we have our challenges. We must give every child a great education, build an economy that works for everyone, end tax breaks for companies that move our jobs overseas. By working together, Democrats and Republicans, we can do these things. That's why we must defeat those who want to turn Americans against one another. I'm Chris Van Hollen, and I approve this message because united, our best days are still ahead.
Oh, Jen? Maria? What have you been up to? I've just been here. What about you?
At the Maryland School for the Blind, our goal is to prepare students to reach their full potential and become successful in the community.
Starters.
I love this first idea. You're using framed photos as the centerpiece. Now, how would you do this if you were having guests?
Well, you know, what I love is the idea that you would put something in the center that people really, like, want to talk about. And oftentimes during this time of year, we're gathering people who haven't seen each other. So I think it's a great idea to ask your guests ahead of time. Submit your favorite image from the year. Submit an image from your favorite vacation, a wedding, something special. And then use the frames around your house to put down the middle of the table.
Yeah.
It's a great conversation starter and gives everybody something to say.
And you can use it as place cards, too. And you don't have to use expensive frames. You can go get the cheap ones or what you got around the house.
Absolutely. And it's a great way to refreshen your frames.
Yep.
I mean, this time of year, people forget because everything's digital to freshen up their frames. So it's a good reminder to do that.
Okay, another super cute idea, books. So not just any books. You're going to get recommendations from your guests, right?
Yes, absolutely. So again, ask your guest ahead of time, hey, what's your favorite read of the year? You know, shift the topic away from politics.
Yes.
As we would say. And put some books down the middle of the table to, again, generate some great conversation and give everybody a reason to participate. And what's really nice about this is if you want to go to the exhibition, it's a great party gift. People can take home a book that they didn't contribute.
Oh, that's great. So it's a party favor. And then I think these movie signs for the placards. How are you doing?
So instead of a typical place card holder, you know, ask everybody ahead of time, what's your favorite TV show of the year? What's your favorite movie of the year? And then use those as the place card holders. So it gives people a chance to kind of walk around the table beforehand and sort of figure out, A, where they're sitting, but B, what everybody else contributed. So again, it gives people a reason to generate a conversation.
Yeah, I love that that's really getting it. It's kind of a unique conversation going. Now, dessert is centerpiece. It's a beautiful idea this time has come. I love it. Tell me about this.
So this is from my favorite bakery, Sweet Henrietta's, but you can use whatever bakery you want. The idea is that desserts so often are relegated to the end. You don't see them. They're tucked away in the kitchen. So if you have a beautiful cake, if you have a beautiful pie, why not let that be the centerpiece? You don't have to go the extra distance of spending the money on cut flowers. You can use your cake as a centerpiece, use some cookies, use your bread as a place card holder. And then, again, really kind of give people the thought that, you know what, if I like what I'm seeing, I'm going to save a little extra room during the meal.
I was going to say, that's always a good reminder for me. Save room for the dessert. Bernie, thank you so much, and congrats on the book, Design Wise.
Thank you so much, Savannah.
Coming up next, the perfect side dishes to go with your fancy centerpiece. But first, this is Today on NBC.
Placido's four steps to selling your home.
Hi, I'm Bob Placido, and I'll price your home right to attract the greatest number of buyers. And I'll provide free professional staging and photography to make your home the best on the block. I'll aggressively market your home to millions of people with our extensive print, social, and digital campaigns. I'll negotiate the best price for your home and represent your best interest. Hey guys, you know there's only one Bob Placido, and I'll work with you personally to sell your home.
In Baltimore, we don't walk backwards. We don't run backwards. So why would we ever let anyone take us backwards? As Senate Majority Leader, I've worked to move Baltimore forward, like building our first new public school in 30 years. Now I'm running for mayor to bring competence, new ideas, and honest leadership to City Hall. Baltimore should be a dynamic, thriving city, not this. If you want new leadership that will move our city forward, not backwards, I hope you'll join us.
My son Philip, who's now 28, has autism. I'm not a big political activist. I'm a mom. But Chris really listened to me.
I thought it was really important to help parents find a way to provide some financial security to their kids.
Chris Van Hollen's work has been instrumental in the passage of the ABLE Act to permit families like mine to save money for their disabled loved one's future. Chris Van Hollen needs to be in the United States Senate.
I'm Chris Van Hollen, and I approve this message.
What is reliable energy? At BGE, it's going to great heights. Laying the groundwork. Managing growing risks.
Two of our special series today include All-Star Thanksgiving. This month, we're pairing chefs to help make your holiday seamless and delicious. This morning, two generations of Italian chefs, Lydia Bastianich of Lydia Restaurant here in New York City, which is serving a special Thanksgiving menu, and Andrew Carmelini. How do you say that? Luca?
Luca.
Luca. Luca, also here in New York. Guys, good morning. Happy almost Thanksgiving.
Buongiorno.
We're making a vegetable that we all agree we've gone 180 degrees on, right? We used to hate them as kids. We love them now, Brussels sprouts.
They're everywhere. People love them. Absolutely. You know, it's all how you cook it, a vegetable. You know, it's you have to caramelize it. Either you're going to roast it, I'm going to saute it in a pan until it gets nice and caramelized so the flavors build.
I read through these recipes. I love them both. They're very different. Just we're starting off by having them. Is that the best
having
way to do
them,
it?
And the leaves like this. And I like to use the leaves as well. You just want to open it up because you know that intense flavor that you feel, that sulfur flavor?
Right.
You kind of release it if you let it out.
Okay, and it's good. Still crispy too. So that's
the leaves.
Yeah, it's like little chips.
And you don't want to waste anything in food, you know?
All right, Andrew, you're going to be on the back deck. Lydia, take me
forward.
Okay, so
here are the ingredients. The Brussels sprouts, we saw how we clean them, a little bit of oil, garlic. Now, bacon is optional if you like it or
not. It's not in my house,
it's minimal bacon.
Yeah.
Okay, so you should take the bacon, and you just take the bacon off, you know, and you drain it off, and you put
it
in the pan.
You leave all that good stuff in the pan.
Exactly. You add the onions to that, just like that. Garlic, if you make a kind of a hot spot here, get the garlic to caramelize very nice. A little bit of pepperoncino. You like spiciness?
Very much.
Okay. A little bit of salt. And this, when everything is kind of caramelized, you add the Brussels sprouts right in. Again, some more salt. A little bit of vinegar, just to give it, and you let it steam.
How long does it steam in?
Oh, about 15 minutes, 15, 20 minutes, nice and easy.
Oh, look at that.
You see? And you want to caramelize it just like that. This is how you want it. This is where the flavors, you know, that green, bright green vegetables. Yeah, they're nice to look and everything, but these taste delicious.
And look how you garnish it in your dish
just
over
like
there.
That. But you know, a little bit of
Walnuts,
just crunchiness and a little bit of flavor.
All right, come on back and join us.
I'll take
Andrew
here.
Thank you, Lydia. All right, Andrew,
okay.
What's different about your recipe?
So,
this
time, you know, I'm thinking about Thanksgiving, and I love apples. I love celery. I love sweet and sour apple and Brussels sprouts.
And I wish people could smell what I'm standing over here. That smells so good.
So, let me put it in the pan. I like to put it in the oven. So, I just salt and pepper, olive oil.
put it in the oven, get it nice and crispy, and then I take apple cider, really, really simple, reduce it by like 3/4, and I add a little apple cider vinegar to it.
So why is that, just to kind of offset the sweetness?
Well, yeah, it's like a sweet and sour, and then apple glaze, very, very American. You put some black pepper in there, kind of like give us a little bit of spiciness.
A little salt.
And then you have this kind of glaze. It's great because the butter, the Brussels sprouts are like a little bit bitter, and you have this like sweetness to it.
I just want to mention we've got people downstairs trying both these recipes.
Really nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Really, really good.
Very delicious.
All right.
And this is a great, you know, Thanksgiving thing. You just put that glaze over the Brussels sprouts. Kind of toss them around a little bit, get them all glazy. And then I have celery root. If you're not familiar with celery, it's a great vegetable in the fall. It's the bottom of the celery plant. If you can't find this, you can use fennel. That'll work really well. And we just, well, kind of intense celery flavor. Really, really good for you. And we make a little salad. We put some fresh apple on there with the apple cider, the fresh apple, and a little bit of the celery root. Breadcrumbs, because I love that kind of texture on it.
Right.
And then, put it in the center. You can do this. You can make the glaze the day before, so you don't have to stress about doing it the day of. Really super.
Guys downstairs, not a competition. You like them both?
They're both delicious.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
You know what's interesting, though? We do have two votes for Andrew's and two votes for Lydia's as our favorite, but everyone agrees all are awesome.
Perfect.
That's the way it should end. We love that. Andrew, thank you very much. Great to have you guys here. Happy Thanksgiving. We're going to be together on November 23rd with 30 other chefs.
Inside every long roofing roof, trust and peace of mind. Call the experts now and you can get a new roof for as little as $99 a month. And you'll get our 50-year full replacement peace of mind warranty.
You put your trust in a nursing home and then your loved one gets hurt. But no one will give you a straight answer. Why not?
Science and Kirk, we'll give you straight answers. Negligent care in a nursing home can result in devastating injuries, such as broken bones, bed sores, or death. If your loved one was neglected or injured, call us right now.
Get the straight answers you deserve. Call Science and Kirk.
Call 1-800-LAWYERS or visit youhavealawyer.com. If you have a phone, you have a lawyer. Call 1-800-LAWYERS.
My thick hair used to turn heads. Now, it's just so thin. I used to get compliments on my hair. Now, no one mentions it. I'm not just missing my hair. I'm missing my confidence. Ladies, it's time to take back your hair and join the Karen League Revolution. We're so sure you can enjoy thicker, fuller, lusher hair. We want to rush you a full-size, risk-free trial of the Karen League System for Hair Regrowth. Just call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-971-5786. The Karen League System is with the only FDA-approved ingredient clinically proven to regrow women's hair, effectively fighting hair loss. Enjoy fuller hair with incredible volume, strength, and thickness. It's time to take back your hair. Join the revolution. To get your risk-free trial, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-971-5786. Supplies are limited. Don't wait. Call 1-800-971-5786.
WJZ Tuesday. A new president will make important decisions that will affect you. Will it be Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump? Who will you choose to lead our country? Under this dome, legislators will shape our future. Who will be Maryland's next senator? Watch WJZ. We'll have a team of reporters around the state, around the country, connecting you with the latest results. Watch all night long. Tuesday it's on WJZ.
Chris Boswell tried to deceive the Ravens yesterday by attempting an onside kick with his opposite foot. As you can see, it did not go well. Baltimore beat Pittsburgh 21-14.
Like he kicked himself. Ouch.
That's it for us. We'll see you tomorrow right here on CBS This Morning.
Thank you.
Susan needed a basement water cooling hero, and thankfully she drove one.
Not to worry.
With two power recliners, only $12.99. Or this way, with three power recliners, only $17.99.
And here's something you don't see every day at Bob's Discount Furniture.
When I changed jobs, I lost my dental insurance.
Wonderful. I think it's acrobatic. How would you describe it?
You know, it's very athletic. We do 90 minutes in a show, up to 8 numbers in a show. Sometimes you can do it up to 4 times a day. So, but to see everybody in the audience and just spread the joy and make time for joy each season is such a wonderful takeaway.
And the cool thing is, if you've seen it, and I've seen it a bunch of times with my nieces, every time you go back, there's something new. You guys change a little something, so it's interesting for everybody, right?
Absolutely. Every season, there's always little tweaks, little changes that we get to, yes.
And can we give a shout out to the Garden of Dreams Foundation?
Absolutely.
I mean, it's fantastic.
Yes, this season, we're so excited to make time for joy. And through the Garden of Dreams this season, we can spread the joy of the donation of tickets. So for every 15 tickets purchased from now until November 15th, we then donate one ticket, up to 2,000 tickets, to the Garden of Dreams Foundation and get to spread the joy to them.
They do wonderful, wonderful
work. By the way, Sarah, you look so good in that hat. Don't give it back.
And you can check out the Radio City Rockettes at the Christmas Spectacular. It runs through January 2nd.
We're back after your local news.
More Americans watch NBC News than any other news organization in the world. Live, local, late-breaking, this is WBAL TV 11 News Today.
Good morning, I'm Mindy Becerra. It's 8:56. WBAL-TV is your home for complete coverage on Election Day. You can watch our election special tonight at 7:30 here on TV 11. And then starting tomorrow morning, 11 News Today will have a look at the candidates, the important races, and the issues on the ballot before you head out to the polls. We're back in a minute with a check on today's forecast.
Michael and Son for all your plumbing, electrical, heating, and cooling needs. And right now, get $35 off.
Michael and Son.
Hi, I'm Rich McKenzie. Why should you use Metropolitan Bath and Tile to remodel your bathroom? Because we have the longest guarantee in the business. We never use subcontractors. All work is done by our own employees. Bathroom remodeling. It's what we do. It's all we do.
Dutch Roper's Burgers, known for fighting terrorism, making sure our troops have the equipment they need, and defending our interests in the world's most dangerous places. But he's also fighting for us here at home. And to us, he's just Dutch.
Dutch got me senior housing. Dutch fixed our Medicare mess.
mess.
Dutch bought for my small business.
Dutch Ruber's Burger, serving Maryland families.
I'm Dutch Ruber's Burger. I heard this ad, and I will never forget where I came from.
I know you won't, because I raised you.
Hi, I'm Rich McKenzie. Why should you choose Metropolitan Bath and Pod? Because we're the top-rated bathroom remodeler in the country. We have four beautiful showrooms with award-winning designers. Bathroom remodeling, it's what we do, it's all we do. And Metropolitan Bath and Pod.
Temperatures climb into the upper 50s by afternoon. Plenty of sun today. The skies are clear, which means it's going to be another cold night. Then we'll be up to 65 tomorrow afternoon. A few showers are possible Wednesday with one cold front. A stronger one arrives Friday into Saturday. Saturday in the 40s. Thanks, Ava. We're back with another weather update at 9:25. Oh, Jen? Maria? What have you been up to? I've just been here. What about you?
Success coaches are here to support your dream and help you plan the next step. Possible starts now at Strayer.edu.
I'm Kathy Shalega, and I approve this message. What's your definition of insanity? Mine is voting the same way over and over and expecting a different result. Like sending Chris Van Hollen to Washington. Higher taxes, huge deficits, a VA that doesn't work. As a career politician, Van Hollen's fixed none of it. Working with Governor Hogan, we're changing Maryland. Next stop, Washington, D.C. Join me.
You know what you'll find at any seafood joint in the South? Hush puppies. Hush puppies, honey. And I'm turning this side dish into a star with my Popeye's Hush Puppy Butterfly Shrimp. 8 shrimp fries and a biscuit for just $4.99.
It's the half-price sale from Master Seal Doors and Windows. Buy one door and get the second one half off. Save on single doors, too. Choose entry doors, storm doors, security doors, patio doors, replacement windows, or aluminum awnings. Call for your free in-home estimate.
A special edition of 11 News coming up in 2016, tonight at 7:30.
This morning on today's take, our buddy Jane Krakowski returning to 30 Rock as our celebrity co-host. Plus, the inspiring weight loss journey of one viewer who dropped an incredible 130 pounds. And double the pleasures we count down to Thanksgiving with two terrific side dishes. Coming up now.
From NBC News, this is today's take. Live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Center.
Hey, welcome to today. It's Monday morning, November 7th, 2016. A lot of folks out there who ran the New York City Marathon yesterday. We offer them our congratulations. Very brisk, but a perfect day for running yesterday.
Very nice.
That's so fantastic. And, of course, we are so thrilled, speaking of fantastic, having our buddy from Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, Jane Krakowski.
Yes, back in.
Yes.
Doing great, everybody. That's the universal symbol for I'm doing great. Kind of not fully.
Really?
You know, it's great to hear that you're filming the third season of Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. We're going to talk about the election in a moment, but I highly recommend, after Tuesday, just get in your bed and watch every episode. It is the most joyous show on TV.
I'm tonight.
I mean, seriously, it brings me so much happiness.
And it's so joyous to film as well.
Really?
In the middle of, well, we're a month or two in of filming season three, which I'm so excited about. And it won't, as in the Netflix plan, it doesn't come out for a little while. But, yeah, it's a great thing to take a break from all of this election stress.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And curl up and hope for the best.
Jacqueline White, your character, who is this kind of self-involved...
I don't know what you're talking about.
...narcissistic, former socialite. What's her deal now? What's going on?
Oh, well, she's fallen in love with someone new now that she's no longer Mrs. Voorhees anymore. And she's trying to make real social change, Al.
You're trying to be a better mom, too.
She's trying to be a better mom, a better person. We're currently trying to get the Washington Redskins to change their name because of her Native American heritage.
Oh, that's right.
So... we're in the midst of all of that, where clearly hilarity will ensue.
Of course. That's what we expect.
You know, it's cool. When your character was inside the hot car, Just please, just watch. It is the best. And also, she loves me. We in movie theaters.
Your Broadway show?
Yeah. Thank you very much. It was a Broadway show that I did. Someone else's Broadway show. I had to go all the way to Broadway. I had to do an entire Broadway show to make it in a movie.
That's right. So
that's what's happening.
This is going to be shown in movie theaters for one night.
One night only. They filmed the show live, and it will air on December 1st.
Has that ever been done before?
I think Broadway HD is the company that is doing this, and I think they did it once with the Shell Company starring Neil Patrick Harris.
Pretty cool.
It's a new thing, yeah, sort of to bring Broadway to the country, to the whole country, if you want to make it here. I'm really excited about it. So it'll be December 1st in 500 theaters around America at 7 p.m. And it's just wonderful for us to sort of relive it again.
Congratulations on that.
Phenomenal. So what did you do this weekend?
What did I do? Oh, what? I can't even remember anymore. I went to see the movie Moonlight. It's an independent film that's getting all of this buzz. It's phenomenal. I mean,
it's not what you expect.
It is not what you expect. I've never seen anything like it. I think it is going to be the front runner for the Oscars. Best picture. I've already put it in. But it is a sensitive portrayal of this young man's life and his journey. I don't want to give too much away. But it's set in Florida, Atlanta. But this story and how this life of this young man is captured, that's when I took the picture at the theater. It's beautiful. I was with a friend, and we were... It's that kind of movie afterwards you keep talking about. And you're filling in the holes. It stays with you. Trust me. Go see it. I'm going to be sitting down with the cast for an interview coming up soon, but it's stunning. It is a stunning work of art.
Wow.
Yeah, what'd you do?
Let's go see it.
It didn't do much. I had a very emotional week with the World Series. This
you
weekend.
Were there.
I was there. You know what? It was so exciting to be part of history, to watch this, to say I was there.
It really was.
I can't remember in my lifetime ever seeing anything like this.
I had to be up really early the next morning, and I was up till after 1 a.m. New York time watching the game, and I was like, oh, this is hurting, but this is the best game I've ever seen.
I know.
You can't turn away. Just to feel the passion of two teams really wanting it so bad and playing the hardest.
Such history for both teams. So whoever won, it was going to be a great story.
And that's all I know.
I just was looking to kind of decompress. And there's a great little place up near where we live called Six Depot. It's an old train station that turned into a coffee shop. And my son and I just had a nice little breakfast yesterday morning, hanging out. He had waffle with Nutella and fruit.
Nicky's eating like a champ. How do you feed that kid?
Oh, please. He finished that and then half of mine.
I can't keep up with this.
I can't keep feeding you. He had a side of bacon besides. He ate my bacon. It was just nice. It was quiet. It was kind of cool. It was very fall-like. Just a nice, chilled.
I got a text from a friend who was there and said, Al Roker is sitting right
Well, look, what are the odds?
And I was like, I wanted to say, well, go say hi, but I didn't. We're at that point in our lives where people connect us even on our weekends and our time off.
Yeah.
I,